eyes closed. We give kindness and respect to our body. We may have aches and irritations, tiredness, tension. But we now look at our body as if it was belonged to somebody else. Are we just looking over it from a distance? Being kind, suggesting to our own body that it relaxes to the max. And not to attain anything or get rid of things, but to be kind for your body to be accepted how she is, how he is. To know that in this moment you are accepted, loved, and respected. As if you're looking over yourself, understanding, caring, with sympathy. And as you look at your body, as it were, from a distance, you give it that freedom to be. We're not going to put more pressure on you, more demands to sit in a specific posture, to tell you to do this or tell you to do that. You look at your body and care. Bring that care to my legs. Opening the door of my heart to however my legs happen to be. Legs, I care for you. As if they were some friend or family member. And it's not your duty or responsibility to tell them what to do, but to give them the freedom to find their best position. So I'm telling my legs to explore. Explore different ways of arranging yourself until you can find the one which you like the most. And legs, I trust you. When you're comfortable, I'm not going to criticize or suggest you do something different. This is your meditation, legs. You get into a nice position. And from a distance, look at my legs with kindness, with care. Wishing them well on this journey of meditation. I go up to my bottom, neglected. So I let my body, my butt just move as it would to find its optimum position of comfort. And having adjusted my butt, I go back to my legs, make sure they're all right too. My whole back. People do get so many aches and pains in their back. So I asked my back, how do you want to sit? What posture do you want to have? I will not second guess. I'll ask my back to choose. My back usually makes really good decisions. If I follow the books, if I follow the shoulds, then I usually hurt you. Instead, I let the back feel. Like the back is an autonomous member of this thing I call body. And let it find its best position. Often we call cats or dogs, especially dogs, they go around in a couple of circles before they sleep, finding the best possible position for their body. So relaxed. In the Australian monastery where I live, you want to find the coolest place during a hot day, it's where the cat is sleeping. The warmest place in a cold day, the cat's got there first. So I trust my back to find its optimum position. My hands and arms. Today my hands don't have to hold a microphone. So I haven't got my hands just one on top of the other with thumbs touching. They've naturally gravitated to be separate on my lap. And I look at them and they're really comfortable down there. Maybe that's not a posture which people recognize as where your hands should be. What they call mudras. I leave mudras to metal statues. My hands are alive, so I let them choose. They feel good. Why move them? My shoulders. What do you want to do, shoulders? Much of my body will move by itself if it's uncomfortable. I just resolve not to stand in the way. To let my body choose. And never think that I know better. My neck, the coughs, the irritations. I tell my throat, whenever you want to cough, it's fine. Don't be afraid. You're not going to disturb others. Others have coughed as well. It's just half of the course. When I'm not afraid of coughing, I cough less. Sometimes we don't want to disturb others, but by holding our body tight, the tension causes more disturbance to ourselves and others. So just let it be. If you want to cough, you can. If you don't want to, you don't have to. When I find the coughing gets less. Feel tightnesses in my face if there are any. There's nothing wrong with being tight around the face. If you want to, the face wants to, fine. But you're kind. allowing things to be. If you allow things to be, you don't have much business to do. Just stay in the present moment. All business is trying to plan out your future, to make it like this, like that. All business is trying to go back from the past. But I found you don't learn from the past. You learn from the present. So to increase wisdom and peace, stay in the present moment. That's where you learn. That's where you grow. And I just remember my poor brain having to do stuff. It's like all my brain cells, my neurons. Guys, you're on holiday. Recess. Turn off your computers, neurons. Take a break. Sometimes you work 24 hours a day. Or the Buddha said, at night time it's like an anthill on fire. Sorry, daytime, anthill on fire, night time it smokes. Sizzles with activity. I look at my brain, put all those fires out. And there's acceptance. There's no work. There's rest, there's vacation. In this moment. You don't hold this moment. You just let go of the past and future. So now is the only time left. It's not a choosing to be aware of something. It's letting go of unnecessary things, past and future. Pretty quickly I'm in the realm of my mind. These emotions, these feelings, even thoughts. I try to remember just what happens before the thoughts. What is the thoughts trying to capture, trying to describe? I don't need to describe things. I don't need to try and remember. When you're mindful and aware, memories are there anyway. You can recall them if you need to. And anything which comes into my mind, I open the door of my mind to it. The door has two functions, to go in and to go out. So when something comes in, I let it go out, keeping nothing. Like Ajahn Chah would say, when you are listening to someone in difficulty, be like a rubbish bin with a hole in the bottom. What comes in, one end. You never keep. Goes out the other. So you are a mind where nothing settles, always empty, ready to receive the next experience. So don't hold on to things. Like you can imagine your mind, just like someone standing at the doorway to greet your guests as they come in. You greet them, you cannot have a conversation with them. There's another guest waiting, right behind. Moment by moment, you know this moment, and you let her go. All you are aware of is like the wind. You don't know where it comes from. You don't know where it goes. You just know it in this moment as it caresses your skin. You don't try to figure anything out. You even let meaning go. You have nothing to do, just being. Not capturing anything, but letting the world be free. Breath comes up. You may begin to notice after a while in meditation that no two breaths are ever the same. You respect your breathing. You're kind to it. Again, not getting too entangled in the breath, just watching it as if through a window. Your breath knows how to breathe. Your job is just to observe without criticism, without giving orders. Your breath needs to be long, it will be long all by itself. If it wants to be deep, it just goes deep. If it wants to pause, it pauses. I just watch. Sometimes it's like being a person who watches birds. They hide. They call it in the hide, making sure the birds don't realize they're being observed. Otherwise you'll interfere with their natural activities. So I pretend to be a bird watcher on my breath. Observe it. It doesn't know I'm watching, as it were. So I recall similarly of a concert. I daren't say anything, otherwise the sound of me doing something will disturb other people's enjoyment of the symphony. I observe, I know, in silence. Just breath coming in, breath going out. I abandon abandon all thought of time. There only ever was one breath, the breath that we know. I don't run forward, thinking where this is going to lead. I don't hold or go back. Just one breath. It's always just been one breath. If I do approach the breath, I hold her hand, my friend, with kindness, with respect. I never try to get anywhere, going places, getting somewhere, achieving things. I let all that go. That's future. It's being. In this moment, kind. I am that lotus with awareness, kindness, respect, gentleness, patience. My lotus opens up. It only opens now in this moment. Like I rest my mindfulness in this moment. I let this moment carry my awareness. And I stand back and let go of my will. I am not going to drive this vehicle called meditation. I'm not going to steer it. Just put it on me, this moment, my mindfulness on now, and let it be. Be quiet. This moment, just being here. Things move around us, change happens, we just stay here, the world happens around us, we don't move. Timeless now. Everything we ever wanted, everything we ever aspired for, we find it's right here, right now. Just being. As a break for 10 or 15 minutes. Please come back if you want to listen to the Sutta class.